time around, let us look at the relationship between expanding and factorizing. What it is, one is the reverse of the other. Whatever can be expanded can be reversed by factorizing. On the other hand, whatever can be factorized can be reversed by expanding. So what it is that, allow me to look at a few examples. And this is very important kind of mathematics, and it is normally taught to pupils who have attended grade 10, 11, and 12, or senior grades. So without wasting much of your time, let us look at this, where you can be taught to expand. Look at that, expand. Expand simply means that you are going to have either one bracket, of which you are going to have a square there, or at times you can have two brackets, or you can have one bracket like that, and outside the brackets you are going to have maybe a 2x plus 1, and there you can have x plus 3, x plus 5, and for this one let's have y plus one, and times you can have what can be minus. All these four under expand. Let me call this as number 1, 2, and 3. So it's not all that difficult to expand these problems. And in most cases, when you expand this, then the result is going to be a quadratic expression. I'm sure that is understood. And to expand simply means to distribute by means of multiplying. Whatever is outside the brackets is going to be multiplied by whatever is inside the brackets. Like in the first place, where you have y plus 1, then squared, then it means that this bracket should be multiplied by another bracket having the same terms or content. X plus 3 in brackets, open and close, and x plus 5 in brackets, open and close. If you expand, you get a quadratic expression. Same applies for this one. There is a 2 outside the brackets, then x plus 1 inside the brackets. Again, if you expand, you see that the brackets are going to be removed and the end result is going to be a quadratic expression. And this is not all that difficult, but simple and straightforward. So how to expand each of the three problems? Number 1 is given to be y plus 1 in brackets squared. It means that y plus 1 again, y plus 1. So to expand this, it's not all that a problem. What you have to do is to look at what the content of the two brackets. This is y plus 1 and y plus 1. Because of squared, the same multiplied by the same. That is the meaning of a square. And this is not all that difficult. So what you are going to do is that this y should appear outside the brackets. Then a plus 1 again appears outside the brackets like that. Then you removed this y independently and this plus 1 independently. If it were to be minus 1, you were to remove a minus 1. Then you maintain that this is y plus 1, the second part, and this is y plus 1 like that. Then from there, y multiplied by y, you are going to get y squared. And y multiplied by 1, you are going to get plus y, instead of writing 1y. And plus 1 multiplied by y, again, this is plus y. Then plus 1 multiplied by 1, this is plus 1. Then from there, you have to simplify this further. This is y squared. Mind you, y squared and a y without a power are two different terms in mathematics. So to treat these two, what you have to do is y plus y, it means 1y plus 1y, then you get 2y and plus 1. And the end result is what is said to be a quadratic expression. I'm sure that is understood. And this quadratic expression can be reversed to the original question by factorizing it. That's why I'm saying the relationship between expand and factorize. One is simply the reverse of the other. I'm sure this is understood. That is how to expand the first question. Then coming to the second question, where you have x plus 3 in brackets, open and close, and you have x plus 5 in brackets, open and close. How do we expand this such a problem? This is not all that difficult, but simple and straightforward. To expand such a problem, what we are going to do is that you have to copy the question. You have x plus 3 in brackets followed by x plus 5 like that. Then from there, what you are going to do is mind you, look at this x. X should be removed outside the brackets. And again, plus 3 moved outside the brackets like that. Then in the second part, you have x plus 5. So you have to write x plus 5 there. Again, you do the same x plus 5 there. I'm sure you have seen how I'm doing it. X to be out and plus 3 to be out. Then x multiplied by x. This way you are going to get x squared. X multiplied by 5 is positive, you get positive 5x. And 3 multiplied by 3x, you get plus 3x. Then 3 positive multiplied by 5, you get positive 15. So if you have observed very carefully, look at this. This is now x squared, 5x plus 3x. 5x plus 3x, you get 8x. And this is plus 15. Again, what we have is a quadratic expression, which is a trinomial expression. So this is not all that difficult to. This is not all that difficult to handle. That is how it should be handled. I'm sure that is understood. And at a later stage, you find that this is going to be factorized in order to get back to the original question, which is x plus 3 and x plus 5. Like I have said earlier on, to say, expand and simplify. One should be the reverse of the other. And this is not all that difficult. You have seen for yourself that I have removed the x there and plus 3. So it means that I have utilized what is in the first two brackets, open and close, x to be out and plus 3 to be out. And inside the two brackets, I have written the second part, which is x plus 5. So this is x plus 5, x plus 5. Then from there, understanding what it means to expand, it means that this x should be multiplied by x, so that you get x squared. And the x multiplied by 5, you get 5x. Same applies, 3 multiplied by x, you get 3x. And 3 multiplied by 5, you get 15. Thereafter, you simplify. Mind you, x squared and that x not carrying a square are two different terms in mathematics. So you have to be very careful when collecting the right terms. So x squared is independent. I have dropped that. Then 5x plus 3x. This is 8x. Then plus 15. And this is a quadratic expression, which at a later stage can be factorized in order to arrive at the original question. So that is the relationship between factorization and expanding. Whatever can be expanded can be reversed by factorizing. We look at question 3. Question 3, we have a 2 written outside the brackets, and inside the brackets we have x plus, plus 1. Still, this question 4 under expand. Can it be difficult to expand such a question? It's not all that difficult, but simple and straightforward. I have to transfer it there. It is question 3. There is a 2 outside the brackets there. Then inside the brackets you have x plus 1. So to expand that, what you have to do is to simply multiply. 2 multiplied by x, you are going to get 2x. And 2 multiplied by 1, you get positive 2. Just like that, you have removed the brackets, of which at a later stage, this problem is going to be factorized in order for it to be reversed to the original question. I'm sure this is understood. At this point in time, the equal sign is not there. When the equal sign is introduced, then it means what we are terming as a quadratic expression can be a quadratic equation. Like for instance, in the first place, we have got y plus 2y plus 1. This is an expression. If I am to show this as an equation, it should be in y squared plus 2y, then plus 1, then equals 0. That way it's an equation. I'm sure that is an equation. I'm saying that is an equation. I'm sure at that point it is seen. This is an equation because I have used an equal sign. Same applies. What I have raised there in question 2 as an expression by expanding x plus 3 and x plus 5 in brackets. This is x squared plus 8x plus 15. This is x squared plus 8x plus 15. Then equals 0. Then it means that is a quadratic equation. And finally, If this were to be an equation, it is going to be 2 x in brackets plus 1 then equals 0. And if an equal sign is used, then it you have to understand that equations at every point should be solved. So this question can fall under solve. And where you have brackets, as you can see, if you are told to remove the brackets, then it means the questions can fall under expand. So allow me to reverse these problems by factorizing. That is what I have got. This is y squared plus 2y plus 1, followed by x squared plus 8x plus 15, and 2x plus 2. Allow me to reverse these questions and to reverse them. These can be reversed by means of factorizing, because what I have explained is expanding. So to factorize, it means that from without brackets, then the brackets are going to be introduced, and this can be done as. So now let us see how these can be factorized. In the first place, I get y squared, the first one, plus 2y plus 1. This is a quadratic expression. For you to factorize this, then you have to raise 1, the product, then sum and the factors. So I'm saying product, sum, and the number factors. Product, sum, and the factors. So how do you raise a product? It is always the first multiplied by the last, the coefficient of y squared. Since there is no number there, this is just y squared, it is 1 y squared, so 1 multiplied by 1, meaning that the product this time it's a 1. I'm sure that is C. Then sum, you just consider what is in between there. This is plus 2y, so you simply get plus 2, which is positive 2. Then the factors, you have to look for the numbers that can be multiplied to get 1, and when added you get a 2. So these factors are 1 and 1. 1 multiplied by 1, you get 1. And when you add 1 plus 1, you get 2. These are the only factors. And at times, in some of the questions, you find that you are going to have a number of factors. That you have chosen the factors to be 1 and 2. They are all positives. And looking at this problem, there is a y used, y squared and y. So better write this 1 to be positive y. And this is positive y, meaning that positive 1y, positive 1y. And at a later stage, this 2y is not going to be shown. In place of 2y, you are going to write y plus y, maintaining y squared and plus 1. And this goes as follows. So I copy the question. This is y squared plus 2y and then plus 1. Then this is y squared, I maintain, in place of 2y, this 2y is not required this time. In place of 2y, you have to write the factors which you have chosen, 1 and a 1. So this is now a y and a y. In case if this were to be showing x squared and x, then this were to be x and x, I'm sure that is understood. So this is plus y, again plus y, then maintaining a plus 1. Then at this stage, this step should be repeated. So this is y squared plus y plus y then plus 1. There is a reason why I have repeated that step. It is going to look different once I bring in the brackets like that and like that. So at this and that looks different now. Then factorizing, remove what is common. So the idea is that this y is going to be removed outside the brackets. Y into y squared, you get a y. Then plus y in 2 plus y, it is plus 1. Then from there, y plus 1. Since this is y plus 1, this is y plus 1, you get a right plus 1 there. Then this is y plus 1. Because if you divide 1 into y, you get y. 1 in 2 plus 1, you get a plus 1. Now, since you are factorizing complete, what you are going to do there is that you have to introduce two brackets in such a way that this is open and close, and that is open and close. Inside the two brackets, write what is outside. This is y plus 1. Y plus 1, those which are outside, this and that, y plus 1. And those which are common, y plus 1 again. Y plus 1. Meaning that y plus 1 multiplied by y plus 1. This is the same as y plus 1 in brackets squared. Another way of writing that is y plus 1, then squared, because the same bracket, what the content of the same bracket multiplied by the same content in another bracket. I'm sure this is understood. This is how this the first question can be factored as follows. So I copy the question in the first place. It is question 2x squared plus 8x plus 15. This is question 2. So in the first place, I have to look for the product. Always the coefficient of x squared multiplied by what is last there, which is c. So 1 multiplied by 15. This is the 1x squared. So I just get a 1 before this x squared multiplied by the last number, which is 15. And the product this time is 15. Then sum, it's not always a problem. Whatever is in between there, this is again positive 8. At times it can be given to be a negative number. So this is positive 8. So positive 8. Then the number factors, they have to be raised in pairs, those which can be multiplied to get that product which you have got, of which in this case it is a 15. So when you say 1 multiplied by 15, you get 15. Then 3 multiplied by 5, you get 15. 4, 5. So these are the factors. So now you have to see to read that. When you multiply, you have to get a product 15. 1 by 15, you get 15. 3 by 5, 15. Now try to see where the two can be added so that you can get what is can be termed to be the sum, which is 8, the one which is in between. So 1 plus 15, can you get 8? No. So these are not the right factors. But 3 plus 5, you get 8. So these are the correct factors. Now, in this problem, there is this x squared and x. So meaning that this is going to be 3x. Which is a positive, and this is going to be positive 5x. So at positive 3x plus 5x, you get 8x, and this is the 8x which is in between. And at later stage, this plus 8x is not going to be shown. And this goes as, this is x squared. In place of x squared, you write the factors you have chosen, plus 3x, then plus 15x, then plus 3x plus, not plus 15, but plus, I have to be fair, the factors which I've chosen plus 3x and plus 5x, not plus 15. So plus 3x, then plus 5x, then followed by plus 15. So what it is that this statement should be repeated. This is x squared plus 3x plus 5x, then plus 15, like that. Then from there, you have to introduce the brackets like that. 1, 1, 2. This plus is part of that positive 5. So make sure that this plus sign should be inside the brackets. Then from there, I'm sure that is understood. The same statement, I have repeated it, but to differentiate it from this, I have introduced the brackets. Then from there, it is at this point that you are going to factor this problem. You are going to remove what is common from the first two brackets, that is open and close. Again, from the first two brackets, second two brackets, open and close, remove what is common in such a way that, looking at this, this is x squared plus 3x. So x is going to be removed outside the brackets. If you remove x, x into x squared, you get x. X into plus 3x, you get plus 3. Then you close like that. There is plus 5x plus 15. 5 can go into 5 once, and 5 can go into 15 three times. So you write a plus 5 there. Then bracket 5 into 5x, you get x. And 5 into plus 15, you get plus 3 like that. I'm sure that is understood. Now look at what is inside the brackets, x plus 3 and x plus 3. This is an indication that you are moving in a right channel. You have to get what is same inside the brackets there. I'm sure this is seen, and at the same time it can be understood. Then finally, factorizing completely, you have to create two brackets in such a way that open and close, again open and close. Try to look at those which appear outside the brackets. This is x plus 5. So this is x plus 5 inside the brackets, and again those which are common, x plus 3, x plus 3, to be collected in one of the two brackets. This is x plus 3. I'm sure that is understood. As you can see, this is reversed. So when you factorize, then it means that you are going to create a bracket from the beginning. If you look at x squared plus 8x plus 15, the brackets are not there. But when it is factored, the brackets can be erased like that. And finally, we look at the third question, which is of which this is 2x plus 4. How can we factor such a problem, 2x plus 4? This is not all that difficult. It can be factored as follows. Let me transfer it there where there is enough space. So at, I show how it can be factored, 2x plus 4. Under factorize 2x plus 4. Then it means that try to look at that, which is the number that can that is common, or letter that is common, that can divide into 2x and then again into 4. It's a 2. So 2 is going to be removed outside the brackets. Then 2 into 2x, you get 2 into 2x, you get x. And 2 into positive 4, you get plus 2. Just like that, you have factored the problem. I'm sure this is understood. You can see for yourself that whatever can be expanded can be reversed by factorizing. And at this point in time, what I have explained, these are expressions. The equal sign is not used anywhere. For expressions, you only expand and you can factorize. You can only solve the equation. If let's say this y plus 2y plus 1 is equals to 0, then it means that this problem can be solved. And the word solve simply mean to work out by means of calculating. And you have to show your stages until you arrive at the value of the unknown. And in this case, where you have y squared plus 2y plus 1. The unknown that way can be a y. Then at last, if it is undersolved, then it means that you are going to get the two values of y as the roots for the equation. So without wasting much of your time, allow me to take you some steps further in mathematics. This time around, let us look at two examples whereby these examples are going to involve minus sign. If you have observed in my examples, all these are full of positive. This is a positive, that is a positive, that is a positive, and that is a positive. That is a positive. So now let us look at two examples which are going to carry a minus sign. And these two examples can be...
The first one is x minus 4 and 2x minus 3. And for this one, you will be told to expand. Let me say this is number one, and number two, let's have a situation whereby we have y minus 5 and 2y plus 3. So from there, you are told to expand. In the first place, let us see how these two can be expanded. Number one, x minus 4, I copy the question. And this is 2x minus 3. To expand such, it's not all that a problem, or at the same time, it's not all that difficult. What you have to do is that you have to look at the content of the first bracket or the second bracket. Remove either the content of the first bracket or the second bracket to be outside the brackets. Let them appear outside the brackets. So in the first place, this is x removed outside the brackets. And this is minus 4 removed outside the brackets like that. Then from that stage, what you have removed is the x outside and minus 4 removed. Then you haven't utilized the 2x minus 3. So inside the brackets, you are going to write 2x minus 3. And this is 2x minus 3 like that. I'm sure that is C. So without wasting much of your time, what you have to do is that you have to expand x multiplied by 2x. You are going to get 2x squared, and x multiplied by minus 3, you get minus 3x, and negative 3 multiplied by that, you get negative 8x. Negative 4 multiplied by negative 3, mind you, negative multiplied by negative, it's a positive, and this is positive 12. It's at this point that you have to simplify the details. And how do you simplify the details? Look. This is 2x squared, negative 3x, negative 8x. This is going to be negative 11x, then plus 12. This is a quadratic expression. I'm sure that is how it should be expanded. And from there, you can move on to the second question and expand
expanding the second question. What I have to do is, in the first place, I have to transfer this question. It is y minus 5 in brackets, open and close, then y plus 2y plus 3. Open and inside the brackets, that is open and close. So there it is going to be. You've transferred the question, now expanding it. In the first place, I remove what is, I look at what is inside the first brackets. This is y minus 5, I remove plus y, then I remove minus 5. Then from there, what I have to do is to write what is in the second bracket. This is 2y plus 3, so I write 2y plus 3, and this is 2y plus 3. Then from there, the brackets has to be removed. This is by means of multiplying out or rather distributing. So this y multiplied by 2y, so that I get 2y squared. So this is 2y squared. Then y multiplied by positive 3, positive 3y, then negative 5 multiplied by positive 2y. This is negative 10y. Then negative 5 multiplied by positive 3. This is negative 15. Like that. This is not the end. If you observe very carefully, there is a 2y squared there. This y is carrying a power 2. And this y and that y not carrying a power 2. So these two are like terms, but the one carrying a power 2 is totally different from these two not carrying a power 2. So in collecting the like terms, you have to be very careful. So these two y squared is independent. Now, positive 3y minus 10y, this is going to be negative 7y, then minus 15. And again, if you look at that, I have expanded that so that I raise a quadratic expression. I am calling it an expression because at this time the equal sign is not used. At a later stage, if it can be equals 0, then it is going to be an equation. I'm sure this is seen. Now, this question is established from expand. I have expanded so that from the beginning, I have the brackets. And by expanding it, the brackets are removed. And at a later stage, what you have seen as answers can be reversed to these questions. And this is by factorizing. That's why I said whatever can be factored can be reversed by factorizing. I'm sure I have to reverse these questions this time around. These are going to be the questions so that I factorize them so that we see how they can be reversed to the original questions. I'm sure this is seen, and at the same time it is understood. So factorizing them, let me factorize each and every question
so this one time after. What I want to do is that look at what we have raised. By expanding this one, we have got this to be the answer. And again, by expanding the second one, we have got that to be the answer. But this time around, I want to factorize these two questions. Let me call this as number 1 and this as number 2. So let us see how the questions can be factorized. I start from the second question, which is question 2. This is 2x squared minus 11x plus 12. Since it is an expression, it can be factored. In the first place, I have to look for the product. The product can be obtained by multiplying the coefficient of x squared by c. So this is 2 multiplied by 12. So this time the product is 24. I'm sure that is seen. Then coming to the sum. The sum, simply the number in between. This time around, it's not a positive 11. It's a negative 11. So negative 11 and positive 11 are two different numbers in mathematics. So you have to be very careful. This is a negative 11. I have considered it to be negative 11. It can be a mistake to write that as a positive 11. Then from there, I look at the number factors. What are the number factors? A factor is simply mean a number that can divide into another number without leaving any remainder. Or at the same time, those numbers which can be multiplied to get the product can be regarded to be the factors. So this time around, I have to raise the factors in pairs. I have to look for those numbers that can be multiplied so that you get a product which is 24. So in the first place, I start from a 1. 1 multiplied by 24, it's 24. So 1 and 24 are factors of 24. And these can divide into 24 without leaving an element. The next number, two numbers, here 2 multiplied by 12. And followed by 3 multiplied by 3 into 24, it is 8. So 3 multiplied by 8. Then from there, 4. 4 multiplied by 6. Because 4 into 24, it is 6 times. Then the next number is 5, 6. So this is the end. As you can see, 4, 5, 6, 6 is already there. So this is the end. So these are the factors of 24. Now from the factors which you have raised, you have to do trial and error method. Try to see, to read that, the two numbers can be added so that you get what is termed to be the sum, which is a negative 11. Now, since this is positive, that is positive, positive, everything is positive. Look at the sum. The sum is a negative. So since the sum is negative, in the first place, I suspect bigger numbers to be negatives. That's why I'm saying trial and error method. Whereas the first numbers remain to be positives. So you should start trying. Positive 1, negative 24, are you going to get negative 11? No. You are going to get negative 21. Positive 2 plus 12, then you are going to get a negative 10. So these are not the factors. Positive 3, negative 8. Still, you cannot get 11. Negative 4, positive 4, negative 6, you are going to get negative 2. None of we haven't raised the factors. If this can be a negative and that can be a negative and that can be a positive, so I have to change my mindset. That's why I said trial and error method. Let me also make the first numbers to be negatives and try to go through so that I see where I can combine the two numbers that I get the sum, which is negative 11. Negative 1, negative 24. I get negative 25. Negative 2, negative 12, I get negative 14. Negative 3, negative 8, I get negative 11. These are the correct factors. I have to be fair. Negative 4, negative 6, this is negative 10. So since these are the correct factors, looking at the question, it is carrying x squared and x. So it means that this negative 3 is going to carry the x. So this is negative 3x. And this negative 8 is going to be negative 8x. So that when you look at negative 3x, negative 8x, this is what is in between, which is 11x. Then from there, I copy the question, which is 2x squared, this one, minus 11x, then plus 12. Then what it is that this negative 11 is not going to be shown at the next stage. So this is now 2x squared. In place of negative 11x, I have to substitute negative 3x, negative 8x. So this is negative 3x, negative 3x, negative 8x. Then maintaining a plus 12 like that. Then upon doing that, this statement should be repeated for a reason. This is 2x squared minus 3x minus 8x, then plus 12. Since I have repeated that statement, this statement and this statement are just the same. But for them to look totally different, I have to bring in the brackets, 1, 2, then the brackets like that. 1, 2, the brackets like that. Mind you, this negative is part of 8. It should not be left outside the brackets, because that way, if you do it that way, then it is going to bring some alterations. So not wasting much of your time. It is at this point that what is in the two brackets, that is open and close should be factored. So to factor the first part, there is 2x squared and 3x. X is common. So this way, x is going to be removed outside the brackets. So that if you remove x into 2x squared, you are going to get 2x. And x into negative 3x, you are going to get a negative 3. Like that. Then looking at that, there is a negative and a positive there. Let me remove a negative and a positive. A negative should be removed outside the brackets. Then looking at 8 and 12, a 4 can go into 8 two times, and a 4 can go into 12 three times. So it's negative 4. If negative 4 is removed, negative 4 into 8, you are going to get positive 2x. Mind you, if you want to reverse negative 4x times negative 4 times 2x, you get negative 8. Now, it is this negative 4 which is going to be divided into positive 8. Mind you, positive 12. Positive 12 divided by negative 4. Positive divided by negative, it's a negative. Then 4 into 12, it is 3. Like that. Now, if you observe very carefully, what is inside the brackets? You have 2x minus 3 and 2x minus 3. This is a clear picture that you are moving in the right channel. I'm sure this is seen. So now, factorizing this problem completely, you have to bring in the brackets. That is open and close, again open and close. Of which, what to write inside the two brackets? You have to collect what is common in one of the two brackets, and this is 2x minus 3. 2x minus 3. And you write those which are outside the brackets in the other. This is x minus 4, so this is going to be x minus 4, like that. Just like that. If you observe very carefully, look at this, x minus 4 and 2x minus 3. Look at this. This is x minus 4, 2x minus 3. That's why I said whatever can be expanded can be reversed by factorizing. Mind you, we expanded this to arrive at that. And again, I have factorized this to get back to that. In the same manner, the second question, or the first question, which is 2y squared minus 7y minus 15, can be treated equally in the same. And this can be done as a follows. This time around, what I want to do is quadratic equations. Look, you have seen that this format, ax plus bx plus c. This is called an expression. And this is a quadratic expression. It can be factorized. At a later stage, you find that this ax squared plus bx plus c equals 0. Then it becomes an equation. And if it is an equation, then you are going to be told to solve. And to solve simply means to work out the value of the unknown by calculating. So now, I established this from a situation whereby two brackets, then inside the two brackets, maybe you have x plus 5 and x minus 1. Or x plus 1. If you expand that, then you get this pattern. But this time around, I want to take you some steps further in mathematics so that we look at what can be said to be a quadratic equation. And in most cases, when you are in grade 12, you never write an exam without coming across a question examined on quadratic equation. I'm sure that is understood. And this quadratic equation can be solved by a number of methods. Let me say method one. This method one is whereby we use a formula. Method two, you can use factors. Mind you, we have learned how to factorize that. It is by factorizing. Let me say factorizing. And all other factors. Method three, it's completing the squares. Completing the squares. And four, this one can be solved by graphical means. This one, four, I'm not going to touch it. It is a function. It is going to be solved by graphical means. Let me say graphically. And when solving this type of an equation graphically, then it is going to be in this form, y equals to ax squared plus bx plus c. And this is called a function. I'm sure that is understood. I'm not going to touch this one at this point in time, but to touch method 1, 2, and 3. If you have been observing from the previous questions, I raised an expression which is y squared plus 2y, then followed by plus 1. This is an expression, but this time I want to turn it into an equation, and this is equals 0, so that it can be ready to be solved. And that is number one. Number two, I also raised the x squared plus 8x plus 15, and this is equals It was an expression without an equal sign, but I upgrade it so that upgrading it, I have applied equals zero so that it can be solved. And the three, I raised the 2x so that we can have one involving the minus sign, minus 11x, then plus 12 equals zero. We can have a number of them, but at this point in time, let me give examples on how these three, each of these three can be solved by using a formula, factorizing and completing the squares. Solving it graphically, not this time, I'm going to prepare a different CD, since solving a quadratic equation by graphical means requires a lot of work. I'm sure if you've been following, let us look at how to solve these quadratic equations. And these are said to be the trinomial type of quadratic equations. I'm saying trinomial in such a way that it is showing three terms, 1, 2, 3, which means A, B, C, and there are A, B, C. That A, B, C, if a question comes, then you are going to find that the question is going to carry 5 marks, and 5 marks are a lot of marks. So solving this quadratic equation can be solved as the first two examples. I have termed this to be A this time, and I have termed this to be B. And the first one is, which is A, is x squared plus 8x plus 15 equals 0. Second one, 2x squared minus 11 plus 12 equals 0. As you can see, each and every question fall under solve. So to solve simply means to work out by means of calculating. So what it is that I am going to use for each question the three methods. One, I'm going to solve it using the factors. Then two, I solve each of the problem using the formula. And three, I use completing the squares. Completing. To cut short, completing the squares. So without wasting much of your time, what you have to do there is that in the first place, to solve by factorizing, I look at the first question. This is x squared plus 8x plus 15 equals 0. In the first place, I look for the product. The product for this one is 1 multiplied by 15, which is plus 15 sum. The sum is positive 8. Whereas the number factors in pairs, I multiply 1 by 15, then 3 by 5. These are the factors. Where can I add the 2 to get the sum, which is 8? It is 5 plus 3. If you add 1 plus 15, you cannot get the sum to be 8. So it is 3 plus 5. So these are the factors. Now, looking at the problem, it is carrying x squared and x. So this is going to be 3x, and this is going to be plus 5x, plus 3x and plus 5x. And you know what it means? In place of this 8x, it is not going to be written. So next step, I'm going to maintain x squared. Then in place of 8x, 8x is not required. In place of it, I write plus 3x, then plus 5x, then plus 15. And this is equals 0. Then from this there, is equals, I repeat the statement, x squared plus 3x plus 5x plus 15 equals 0. Repeating the statement that way, then what I have to do is to bring in the brackets like that. The idea is you have learned how to factorize. The idea is you just factorize the first part. Now factorizing this is going to be x to be removed outside the brackets, x into x squared x, x into plus 3, this is plus 3. Brackets, this is plus 5. 5 into this is x. And 5 into 15, it is plus 3. And this is equals 0. I'm sure that is seen. Now from there, factorizing completely the brackets like that, and this is equals 0. What is outside? X plus 5. This is x plus 5. And this is x plus 3, the ones which are common. Now, in mathematics, there is what we call a zero product property. If let's say you have A,
multiplied by b and the product is 0, then it means that either a is equal to 0 or b is equal to 0. Same applies when you have a bracket and a bracket. Maybe this is a and b equals 0. Then it means either a is equal to 0 or what is in the second bracket and this is b is equal to 0. So this is now the property which I'm going to use, and I'm calling this property as a zero product property. Zero product property. In mathematics, once you come across a zero product property, this is what normally happens. So when you look at this, what is in the first bracket? X plus 5 in brackets and x plus 3 in brackets equals 0. Then it means that you have to separate the two by saying either x plus 5 is equal to 0 or x plus 3 is equal to 0. Then from there, you solve this as an independent equation. This is x equals 0. If this plus 5 crosses the equal sign, this is minus 5, and x is equal to negative 5. Or same applies, this is x is equal to 0. If 3 crosses the equal sign, minus 3. And that way, this is going to be x is equal to 0 minus 3, negative 3. So as you can see, I trust I have got the values of x. X is equal to negative 5 and x is equal to negative 3. I'm sure this is how to solve the quadratic equation. And the method which I have used is factorizing. So I have solved this by factors. Now, if the same problem can be solved by using the two remaining methods, formula or completing the squares, still the same results must be maintained. I'm sure that is understood. That is how to solve the problem by factorizing. So allow me to solve the same problem, but this time around using the formula.
Using the formula.
Using the formula. What it is that for the formula, you have to write x is equal to negative b, positive or negative. Then followed by square root b squared minus 4ac. What is inside the brackets, b squared minus 4ac is said to be the discriminant. Then this is over 2a. Mind you, the dividing line should reach where the equal sign ends, meaning that this 2a is being divided into the whole lot of that. Most of you tend to make a mistake. If the dividing line can end there, then what it implies is that this 2a is just being divided into the discriminant. So to present the formula correctly, make sure that the line reaches there. I'm sure that is seen. Now, if you look at this, this is ax squared plus bx plus c equals 0. So which means that a is equal to 1, b is equal to 8, and c is equal to 15. I'm sure that is seen. If I am to indicate the values from this, look at this. This is x squared plus 8x, then plus 15 equals 0. So looking at this, ax squared plus bx plus c equals 0. Then it can be seen clear that a is equal to 1, b is equal to 8 positive, and c is equal to 15. Now, what you see in this formula, as you can see, there is a, b, and c. So when the formula should be remembered by at, mind you, looking at this, x is equal to negative b outside the brackets, positive or negative, then the square root b squared minus 4ac. B squared minus 4ac. 4ac means 4 multiplied by a multiplied by c, then divided by 2a. All you need to do is to start substituting in this formula. So this is x equals negative is part of the formula. Then what is b? B is positive 8. Since it is positive 8, there you write it 8, then square root b, which is 8 squared minus 4ac. 4 times a is 1. And c is given to be 15, multiplied by 15, like that. Then everything over 2 times a, which is 2 times 1. And that is x is equal to negative 8, positive or negative, square root, 8 times 8, this is 64, minus
4 times 1 is 4, 4 times 15, this is 60. Then over over 2 times 1, that comes to 2. Then from there, this is now x equals negative 8, positive or negative. 64 minus 60, you get a difference of 4, and not throwing away the square root. 64 minus 60, this is a 4, and this is over a 2. Then from that stage, you have to move further. This is x equals negative 8, positive or negative, square root of 4 is a 2 over 4. Now, it's at this point that you are going to separate a positive from negative. Because of positive and negative, then you have to say either x is equals to negative 8 plus, you use plus first, plus 2 over 4, or negative 8 minus 2 over 4. I'm sure that is understood. Why over 4? Look at that. Mistakes are there to be controlled. This is 2a. A is 1. Mind you, 2 times 1, it's 2. And again, there it's over 2. But where is this 4 coming from? Mistakes are there to be controlled. So this is not a 4, but it's over 2. Even there, it's over 2. So mind you, x equals negative 8, positive or negative, 2 over 2. Then either x is equals to negative 8, positive or negative, not over 4, but over 2. I'm sure that is seen. And even there, it's over a 2. Over 2, and there it's over 2. Then from there, you have to simplify that. This is now x is equals to, mind you, negative 8 positive 2. Negative 8 positive 2, this is going to be negative 6. Negative 6 over 2. Or this is negative 8 negative 2, which is negative 10 over 2. Then from there, this is going to be negative 6 divided by 2. This is negative 3. Or negative 5 divided by negative 10 divided by 2. This is negative 5. And again, if you can take into comparison, these are the same result that I raised by solving the same problem, which is x squared plus 8x plus 15 equals 0. That is by using the factors. And this time around, I have used the formula to solve the problem. I have got the same results. I'm sure that is understood. Either x is equals to negative 8 plus 2. So this is negative 8 plus 2. That comes to that. And negative 8 minus 2 comes to that, which means negative 8 negative 2, it's negative 10 over 2. And this is negative 10 over 2. And that way, when you divide, you end up getting a negative 5. So x is equals to negative 3, and at the same time, x is equals to negative 5. I have used 1 factors, then 2 on the formula. So to be fair, allow me to use the square root plus 8x plus 15 equals 0. This time, I want to solve it by completing the squares. What it is that you have to copy the question as x squared plus 8x plus 15 equals 0. This time around, this 15 should cross the equal sign. And if 15 crosses the equal sign, the question reduces to x squared plus 8x, then equals negative 15. I'm sure that is seen. Then from there, you make sure that this can be only x squared. If this were to be 3x squared, you were to divide each and every part of the equation by 3. But the way it is, it's okay. So now, the best you are going to do is that you look at what is in between there, which is 8. It's positive 8. Just consider 8. This 8 should be multiplied by half. And this half should be raised by power 2. So half of 8 is a 4. 4 to the power 2, which comes to 16. I'm sure that is understood. Always, whatever is in between there, just get a number, multiply it by half, and the result should be raised by power 2. Like in the case, this is 8, half multiplied by 8, then the result raised to the power 2. I'm sure that is seen. There is a reason why I'm doing that. Then half of 8, it's a 4. 4 to the power 2, it's 16. Now, this is 16 should be added to both sides of the equation.
So this is x squared plus 8x. I leave a gap equals negative on 15. I am saying this 16 should be added to both the sides of the equation. Plus 16, you add d plus 16, and this side you add plus 16. I'm sure that is the season in between there. This is 8. 8 multiplied by half, then the result to the power 2, and the result comes to what? 16. Half of 8 is 4. 4 to the power 2 is 16. 16 must be added to both the sides of the equation. I have added the 16 this side and the 16 this side. In the first place, you have seen that I just transferred this plus 15 to the other side of the equation, so that this time it's 15 positive. If it crosses, upon crossing it to the other side of the equation, it becomes a negative 15. Then from there, you have to proceed. This is now x squared plus 8x plus 16 equals negative 16 plus negative 15 plus 16. This is positive 1. I'm sure that is a sin. That is positive 1. Now, what it is, upon adding this 16 and that 16 to the other side, then it means that this gives rise to that, and this is equal to 1, which is the result obtained by combining negative 15 plus 16, which is a positive 1. Now, this time around, what is in between there, which is 8x, is not going to be regarded. Look at x squared. Square root of x squared, it is x, and square root of 16, it's a 4. Now, the sign to write in between there, and the sign which is there, if this were to be negative, you were to drop a negative. This time it's a positive, so you drop a plus there. I'm sure that is understood. So that at this point in time, it is x plus 4. Then not forgetting that this is squared. X plus 4 squared is equals to 1. Now you have to solve this quadratic equation. What it means is that this is raised by power 2. So what it is that x plus 4 in brackets squared equals to 1. You have to find ways and means of transferring this power 2. This is by bringing the square root this side and the square root that side, and this is positive or negative. I'm sure that is understood. Square root and power 2 cancels, and this is x plus 4 equals positive or negative. Square root of 1, it's a 1. Then from there, to look at this. What it is that transfer this 4 to the other side of the equation. It is going to be, mind you, this is positive 4. If it is crosses, it becomes minus 4. Then you maintain positive or negative, and this is 1. I'm sure that is understood. And it is at this point that you can say either x is equal to negative 4 plus 1 or negative 4 minus 1. I'm sure that is the scene. Then from there, this is x is equal to negative 4 plus 1. This is negative 3. The first value of x, or negative 4, negative 1. This is negative 5. So, and again, if you can take into comparison from the previous methods, x was obtained to be negative 3 and x to be negative 5. What is important is to put this into practice. I'm sure that is the scene. I have solved this problem by one using the factors. This is question A, x squared plus 8x plus 15. Then two using the formula, and three using the completing the squares, and they have been maintaining the same answers. I have to do the same to the second example, which is the example number 2.